What's up, everybody? It's Polish Pete. I'm at our headquarters in Golden Valley, Minnesota, and this is the tackle breakdown of the Strike King Menace Grub. So the Strike King Menace Grub, to me, right now, on the marketplace of soft plastics, the whole world of soft plastics, is probably the most versatile I can think of. This bait gets used in dozens of different applications, and it's become a confidence bait for a lot of anglers. For me personally, I look at it as a tool in my boat that I can use in almost any part of the country, anywhere I want to go fishing, any time of the year. There is a way to rig a menace grub and get a bite. This bait has started to become a favorite as a chatterbait trailer, a trailer on a buzzbait, a Carolina rig, flipping bait, a jig trailer, all of the above and even more. So I wanted to go over all the different sizes in the family. We have the Baby Rage Menace here. So this is a really small finesse model here. A lot of people like to throw it on just a small finesse swim bait style head. This right here happens to be the Smeltonator, the jig head that our friend Gussie won an Elite Series event with this year. This little jig head comes out of Canada. It is an absolute smallmouth killer, and rigged up on a little Baby Rage Menace like this and just either pendulum fish through the water, it could be hopped along the bottom, it will get bit. It is a killer little bait, and it's very versatile as far as being fished in more of those traditional grub techniques, like being just fished on a jig head or even just with a Texapose hook and weightless and just swam through the water. This is a cool little bait that'll get you bites in tough situations. You move up to the 4-inch size here, and this is my confidence size. I have a whole bunch of different colors in this and a whole bunch of these in my boat. I use this jig trailer on the back of a stealth biter when I'm vertically fishing a jig and in deep submerged vegetation like coontail or milfoil. I think it's a great trailer for that. A lot of people have been using this on a swim jig, like this style jig here from Sixth Sense. You thread it up on here, it could be skipped under docks and swam. One of the tricks to this bait, when you get into the 4-inch or up into that magnum size in the Rage Menace, is you can fish it either horizontally, like you would a traditional craw type trailer that swims, or you can fish it vertically where the tail's actually straight up and down. And it gives it actually more of a minnow profile. So it makes it a very versatile chatterbait trailer or swim jig trailer as well. When you want to mimic the forage a lot more, then turning that tail straight up and down will make it obviously look a lot more like an actual fish's tail fin that's straight up and down and not flat. If you're trying to mimic crayfish forage down towards the bottom, that's when you want to rig it horizontally so those tails flip up and down like that. One of the things that I saw with this bait personally that kind of shocked me was how good it is as a punching or a flipping bait. I got to witness Mark Zona absolutely wreck him on these things when I was trying to say craw tubes are the only way to flip in this situation. This bait is incredible with a big weight on it. If you go 3/4 and up and Texas rig either the new Magnum size or the traditional 4-inch, this thing will absolutely race through cover and kick super hard with these big flanged tails that are on the edge and end of all the Rage plastics. This is a patented process that Strike King has on the Rage baits that make them just kick like crazy. So with a big weight on it, you're getting that reaction bite through a mat. And if you're fishing anywhere with matted vegetation or really thick stuff that it's hard to get a bait through, because of its grub-shaped body, it'll snake through that cover and it'll kick like crazy. So when you're looking for a bait in your boat to use in multiple different applications, there really isn't one better than the Strike King Rage Menace.